So we got our first patch and or tuning update for NBA 2K19. Now, if you've been following the boy Mike Wang on Twitter, he made it clear yesterday night that there was gonna be some changes.
What? There's gonna be some, you tell me what? All right, okay, that's what I like to hear.
Some people's reaction was very different. They were like, oh my God, the game is perfect. I can't believe you touched the perfect game.
I was like, you think the game is perfect? Wait, you think it's all right to shoot contested shots? Is that what you think? You really believe that?
I get it. At this point, it's been like 2K17 and 18, and we had the same recurrent cycle where one thing would change and it'd ruin something else. Then to change that, you'd ruin these two things, and it'd be a cycle of just overlapping cycle of bullshit. Mike Wang said at the event that, yo, the game's gonna drop and we're gonna see what the community's talking about, and if there needs to be any changes, I'ma make it. Just wait for a second. Let's reflect on how people are going crazy for no reason. You mean to tell me a AAA development studio like Visual Concepts publishes the game, 2K Sports, NBA 2K19 lands, you think they're gonna make zero changes to the game? You think no changes would possibly be necessary, that the game testers did a perfect job? You trust the game testers? My guy, I even asked Mike Wang at the event, I'm like, who is testing these games? I'm like, Mike, you might have to get me out there, my guy. You might have to get a dribbler out there.
A dribbler out there.
This video is sponsored by SeatGeek. SeatGeek, of course, is the app that helps making buying tickets more affordable and easier. Ladies and gentlemen, like the last year of events I went to, all SeatGeek. Like, it had some really funny moments. You guys remember 7-8 months ago, went to the Raptors game, I brought my Nintendo Switch, was playing NBA 2K18. Now, I did pull up in the middle of winter with some shorts and garnered some attention from the security. It was entertaining. And you know me, I'm not gonna say no to an opportunity to go to a Raptors game. For any event, whether it's comedy, sports, a musical event, SeatGeek is the place to go. I'm gonna leave a link in the description, click it. You can use code AGENT and get $20 off your first purchase.
We now return to your regular programming.
For example, if you've been playing on the park, you've came across this bullshit.
Watch the pick. Oh, he's a bitch. He's actually a bitch. If they...
I cannot believe people actively do that. They cheat in the game just to win. That shit is pathetic to me. It's one thing to do it, you're trolling, you're up 10 already, or maybe you've already lost the game and you don't really care. It's another thing to, in the middle of a game, on a game-winning shot, decide to use a cheat. And people do it. You give people an opportunity to cheat, they're gonna take advantage of it. And it's the same thing that goes with these sliders. All right, you cannot sit there and think that shot contest should be left the way it is. It just should not. And I get that in the process of maybe trying to solve that thing, you might mess up another thing. And that's kind of what happened this morning. So the update dropped around like 5 a.m. I went to sleep at 3 a.m. so I woke up and heard all about the news. People were going crazy on Twitter. The main thing I was hearing was that people were missing more open releases, but they were still hitting the contested releases. So actually, let's backtrack. For those of you who didn't read the tweets, I'm gonna read those first just so you can get filled in. So Mike Wang says, gameplay tuning update tomorrow morning brings a better balance to perimeter, buff, versus inside, nerf, shot contest for fewer blown layups and less OP outside shooting, and also a slight reduction in effectiveness of steals out of body ups and fadeaway threes. Gonna be honest with you guys, that last part to me made no sense. If you're already taking smart shots, you shouldn't feel much of a difference. This update will just help reward good perimeter defense and punish people for forcing contested shots. I should probably make it even stronger, but I don't wanna make any drastic changes. So when we saw this tweet last night, everybody was just looking at each other like, Mike Wang is undefeated. Mike Wang, so far in NBA 2K19, is undefeated. He's been saying all the right things, doing all the right things, and aside from like a few issues people were having in terms of the gameplay and the sliders, everything was straight. I think everybody adjusted to the passing lane steals, those should be kept the same. So that's what we expected to happen. I can tell you right now, after playing today, contested shots did not go down. They didn't at all. But for me, unlike some people I'm hearing on Twitter, I'm not missing more open releases. Again, the only time I miss time my jump shot is when I assume low latency and I'm playing in high latency or vice versa. For example, today I was playing, I hopped on the park and I grabbed two guys. I'm like, yo, let's play. And then we started to do that. Weirdly enough, this was the first time I played 2K19 and there wasn't like a massive crowd around me. So here I am using my high latency jump shot, but because there's no crowd, I was playing on low latency and I was missing shots. So I just switched to my low latency jump shot the next game and I was perfectly fine. But at no point during that did I think I was missing more or less open shots because of this new update. There's a good possibility some of you guys just shooting bad releases. Now, wouldn't that be a sad realization? Mike, I know Mike knows. The Baluba himself, he will not fall for the same trap. I have to have that faith. There is no way after 2K17 and 18, we're gonna go through exactly what we went through those last 2 years. It would change over and over for no reason. Just always changing the game. Listen, if there's a change that has to be made to stop something really overpowered, go ahead. But the second we just start like changing things and then ruining other things and then the list of things that were ruined because of changes to fix other things increases, then we gotta stop and reflect. At that point, just leave the game alone, right? So Mike, I'm telling you right now, whatever you changed, it did not do what you intended it to do. I'm still seeing contest. All we really want is when we put a hand up for a contested shot, especially on those shot craters. I know, cause I have one. Them shits should not be dropping the way they are. That's all it is. Whatever you changed last night, didn't have that effect. I was still missing open layups with my play shooter. Weirdly enough, this year, it's not sharpshooters that have the worst layups, it's playmakers. So my sharpshooting playmaker, my play shooter, yo, it is the worst build at attacking the rim. I have clips of me missing wide open layups. You haven't really changed much, have you?
Alert, there's been an update.
Guys, there's been some more changes to the game. As expected, the desirable effects just wasn't there and Mike Wang's seen that. And now he's put in a pretty hard spot because here's what he said basically on Twitter. All right, maybe we need to come harder at this. Did a follow-up tweet saying,
"We're coming with the shits."
I feel like people are mad anytime anything changes, even if it makes sense that it changed. There's plenty of people I'm seeing on Twitter complaining about people complaining about shot contests. Oh my God. Oh shit. This is a $3,000 camera. Probably should be more careful. Yo, I really genuinely feel like grinding my shot maker just so I can drop off these people pretending like there's no problems with shot contests. I get that you're worried something's gonna break because of a new change, but it's not perfect the way it is. Oh my God, I was just playing on the stage yesterday before this newer update, and I had this one shot that I was streaming this on Facebook too. Follow my streams, link in the description. And the shot he hit had me feeling some type of way. People just shooting in people's eyes. Weren't you the same people who said you didn't want contested shots before the game launched? What changed? Cause now we're in a situation where contested shots are hitting. And you might have a f***ing fantastic release, my guy, but you should not consistently be hitting contested shots. Because at that point, we're not rewarding good defense. And so there's a balance to be had. And I think all Mike Wang is trying to do is find that balance, but every time he puts out a post, there's someone angry about it. If Mike Wang does something real stupid, right? Like, if he made a change where, like, very early releases started hitting 25% of the time, we would all have the right to flame him. But right now, he's trying to balance the game. That's what happens with video games. Do you guys know that? I think some people are void of the logic. In video games, it releases, and then there's problems with balance. And then inevitably, in yearly releases, they try and find that balance by nerfing guns, or in this case, changing the fucking sliders so it's a fair, balanced game. Guys, if you don't think something should happen with shot contests, you're basically begging for everybody to create a shot creator and a sharpshooter. Cause that's exactly what's gonna happen. Waleed hit me up, said he's making a new account. What build should I make? The obvious answer is Shot Creator. It's the easiest build to pick up and be good with. And on top of that, it's not just easy to pick up, it has the highest ceiling because it's easily the best build because of the problems with shot contest. And I feel very confident in giving him that advice because there's no better build. Oh my God, there's problems with shot contests. Jesus. Anyway, really, we know the problem exists. I think at least most people do. It's just a matter of like how Mike Wang handles it. Cause sometimes he be doing things and then like the opposite thing he wanted to happen, sometimes happens. So with the new update, a lot of people have been complaining that like, yo, now I only have to put a hand up and it counts as a lightly contest. Yo, now this counts as a contest. Oh my God, guys. Maybe he needs to tone it down a little bit, but it's much better now than it was before. I know that. You know what's funny is we all want the same thing. Everybody just wants a fun game with a skills gap that's balanced. But then, like, in the process of attaining that thing, everybody wants to attack it from different ways, or some people just have different definitions of things like balance or skills gaps. I'm curious to see how this plays out, ladies and gentlemen. I doubt Mike Wang is gonna make changes throughout the entire year. There's two main complaints people had. He attacked the steals complaint. Steals are much better. No one had a problem with the passing lane steals, but poking the ball if you're not a lockdown should not be that successful. On a side note, lockdowns might be, I know I give shot critters a lot of flack, but lockdowns might just be the best build in the game. Every time I play with a lockdown, my guys, it's wins and wins and more wins. If you ever do have a problem with your neighborhood shot creator or sharpshooter, just bring a lockdown along and I guarantee you they will not be dropping buckets. Anyway, that's not all the issues that the game is having. Like, Pro-Am is an entire minefield right now. I don't even want to create a Pro-Am team. I'm gonna just let them handle the Pro-Am issues, and until then, I'm gonna just kick it and grind my badges in the park and on my career. I get that it can be hard. Like, I want one thing, or maybe the next guy wants something else. Like, sometimes people are split, right? The community feels this way and that way. And then Mike Wang has to sit there and make a decision on which way is best. And in the process, you're inevitably, anytime you make a change that affects people's archetypes, get people pissed off. Especially if you just took the best archetype in the game and made it worse. And then people are like, yo, I just, you know, this is the money and time I spent on the player that just got made worse. I want that back. Or they have to grind over again and spend more of that stuff. More resources, more time, more money. For example, let's start to name some things broken with 2K19. I think all of these can use a fix. If I send an invite to somebody and they accept the invite to join my playground, they get sent to a different playground. If they join me using their phone in game, they get sent to a different playground. If they try and join me on the party, they still get sent to a different fucking playground. How about the next thing? Why is it possible that two different teams can hop on the squad spot and glitch the court? And for the court and the game to continue, somebody has to close their app. So if my teammate closes app, the game starts. But we were already playing. We were already playing. And then I got a loss today because I closed app a little too late because the Gotnex glitched. Let's talk about that. Come here. Why is the game blue screen so fucking much? I mean, I have never played a 2K that blue screen this much. Literally every 5 or 6 playground games, either there's a Gotnex glitch or my game crashes. Why are people playing my career games and getting no my points for all the progression they made in that game? Why do the rep rewards like a skateboard or a megaphone cost so damn much? I was watching G-Sice's stream and he bought a 250,000 VC megaphone. And then he used it and it was so underwhelming. You can't even use it in the park. You have to be on the outside of the park. Oh my God, I was like, damn, the megaphone had so much potential. Not only does it cost an arm and a leg, but it's barely useful. It might make for a funny video, but if I'm not a YouTuber, I'm not buying that shit. It is literally $50. 250,000 VC. $50 to buy that in-game megaphone. That is useless. I can't even imagine what mascots are gonna cost. How about when I check the ball to somebody and instead of passing it like a regular basketball game, they just dribble. They just decide to dribble. There's no first man. They don't have to pass to that guy first. They could just score. It happens a lot on the twos, but it's been happening more and more on the threes. How about when I change my jump shot and then I hop in a game and then it didn't change the jump shot that I wanted it to change to? Guys, what I'm trying to say is there's a lot of problems with the game. And I'm sure they're working to iron out said problems. And I hope they do it sooner rather than later, because I didn't even touch on all the Pro-Am stuff. Minefield, I don't even want to talk about that. I think that this game, with all its problems, is still much better than NBA 2K18. There's a lot going for it, right? Aesthetically, like, they have these, I played Red Ball, Blue Ball for the first time. Corny ass game, but it's neat that they put it in there. They're giving people reasons to come back every single day with events like Dodgeball, where you win 25,000 VC if you're the last guy. It's dope that the park changes themes all the time. It makes it refreshing to continue playing. You're not looking at the same thing every time. Like Call of Duty, you play on a different map every game. Rainbow Six is a different map every game. Imagine if you had to play on Bartlett's University every single game on Rainbow Six. You would lose your mind. So I'm just trying to say, for what it's worth, some people are beginning to panic because this was the first update that we got in NBA 2K19. And I can see why. There's been a lot of evidence in the past of us going down the same route. I'll put it like this. Fool me twice, shame on, okay, let me stop. It's not a quote. There's not much wrong with the game in terms of gameplay and sliders. Just tweak one or two things, pop, pop. That's all you need, then leave it alone. At that point, you can start focusing on the other glitches and the bugs, right? I'm back to daily uploads. If you guys are new to the channel, be sure to subscribe. Click on one of these two videos. If you haven't already, drop a like. And if you didn't do any one of those things, I'm fighting you, all right? I'm gonna catch you guys later. I'm out. Peace.